But a computer is a television. Let's just close that loophole right now. A computer is a TV. It's called computer TV. I love computer TV. I watch it at work. That's how I keep up on all my stories. And by stories, I mean cat videos. I love cat videos. I love cat videos. I saw this one video of this cat. This cat, he jumps into this box. Then he jumps out of the box. Then he jumps back into the box. And just when you think he's gonna stay in the box, he jumps back out of the box! And he does this over and over and over again for 9 minutes and 38 seconds. I know, because I watched the whole fucking thing. I loved it! I loved it, and millions of people have watched this video. Millions of people love this video. They've seen this video of this cat jumping in and out of this box. It's really popular. And I was thinking to myself, I wonder how other popular things do on YouTube. And I was thinking, you know who's popular? The president. He's a popular guy. He also makes YouTube videos. Don't know if you know that. He considers himself something of a filmmaker. He does. He's got his own little YouTube channel, and I figured, I wonder how one of his videos would do compared to this cat video. So I went to go look at one of his videos, and it was a video where it was talking to people about what you could do to help those in the Gulf region who'd been affected by the Gulf region. People had watched that video. 500. I felt so bad that I kept hitting refresh over and over again. Because this is the president of the United States, and he is getting his ass handed to him by a cat and a box. That's embarrassing. Like, I feel so bad for him that I feel like anytime he's in town, I just want to run behind him with some cats and some boxes. Like, just throw him in the background. Don't tell him, but just let them hang out in the background and do their thing, because their approval rate never goes down. It doesn't. People love cat videos. Here's how much people love cat videos. I love cat videos. I hate cats! That's ridiculous logic! I hate the Boston Red Sox. I don't go buy season tickets to go see the Boston Red Sox, because that would be stupid! But I love cat videos, and I don't know why. I wish I understood why, and I've tried to understand why. I've spent many hours thinking about why. I figured, you know what I'll do? I'll just read the comments that other people have left on these videos, because maybe that could give me some insight as to why I like them so much. So I started going through the comments, and it's typical stuff like, you know, ha 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 ha. ROTFL. Which I know that means rolling on the floor laughing, but I like to think it means reaching out to fellow losers. But I'm going through the comments, and I finally see this one comment that stops me in my tracks. And this is a comment. It said, "Oh my God, I want that cat. That nigger is adorable." Here's the thing. This cat was not black. It was adorable. That was the right adjective. But I don't know what this cat did to become a nigger. Like, it's just a cat happily jumping in and out of a box. Like, I could understand if it was jumping in and out of a box of Newport cigarettes. That's an adorable nigger cat. That is, because he's got to be really tiny to jump in and out of a cigarette box. How could you not love that? Or if the box represented the duality of trying to live in a homogenized society while at the same time struggling to hold on to your fragmented cultural identity and because those two worlds are constantly in conflict, you must jump between them like a nigger cat. But to just call the cat a nigger because you don't know any pronouns, that's silly. And here's the thing, I know black people that use the word nigger. I know black people that say it. I know black people that say it a lot. I used to say it a lot. I don't really say it that much anymore because I work a job. Where I'm one of the few black people. Y'all didn't let me finish. You racists. I work a job where I'm one of the few black people, so it's not very professional to be like, hey, nigga, you got a fax. Who's he talking to? It's just him and Andre who work here. Seems really rude. He could have just said, hey, Andre, you have a fax. So I don't say it that much, but I understand people who do say it, and I understand the argument that a lot of black people have for saying it. A lot of black people say they say the word nigger because they're co-opting it. They're taking it back and taking the hateful power out of it. Sounds like a good idea. I'm curious to know when we're actually going to get the hateful power out of it. Like, is it a tit-for-tat thing? Do I have to say two niggers for every time someone else said it? Like, what do I have to invest into this reclamation project? Because it still seems pretty hateful, still seems pretty powerful. We're definitely desensitized to it. Like, we're desensitized to it because you can watch, like, a Laker game. You'll see a Laker game, and you'll see, like, Ron Artest or somebody, and it'll be like, hey, nigga, I'm open. It's not a big deal. It slips through the broadcast. There's no FCC fine. Somebody passes him the ball. But let Jack Nicholson get up from the sidelines, like, yeah, nigga, he's open. You can't handle the rock. That's problematic. Jack Nicholson's gonna have to do some Hanes commercials with Michael Jordan. Hope people forget. Calling a cat a nigger. Here's my other problem with this. You call a cat a nigger, then you can't go and get mad when other people want to use that word because you're throwing it around like some kind of black Smurf. Smurfs never got mad at that. If Gargamel was like, I'm feeling pretty Smurfy. No Smurf was ever like, oh, homie, hold up a second. Oh, no, you need to Smurf that right now. No. See, let me explain something to you. That is a term of ensmurfment between me and my Smurf brethren. So you need to Smurf the hell on out of here. Take your damn nigga cat Ezreal with you. Go.